After mastering all of the techniques covered in session 2, you're already able to do useful work with the world's most powerful business tool. But of course, you're only on the first rung of a very long ladder. Most of the skills covered in this session will take your powers beyond those of casual Excel users. This 5-minute preview is designed to enable you to quickly review all of the skills you're going to master in session 3. If you already have some Excel experience, this 5-minute preview may enable you to skip over some or all of the lessons in this session. So let's start the clock ticking and begin the preview. In the first session, I'm going to show you how to insert and delete rows and columns using this sample file. I'll show you how to insert a row above row 3 and insert a column to the left of column A. And then I'll show you how to insert several columns all at once in one operation. In the second lesson, you'll learn how to select a value from a drop-down list, displaying all of the unique values in the column above. In the third lesson, you'll learn to cut, copy, and paste. You'll copy these cells and then paste them into a different location in the workbook. In lesson 4, you'll take cutting, copying, and pasting to a new level using drag and drop. You'll drag some cells and drop them into a new location in the worksheet. And you'll also understand how to use all of the options available when you cut, copy, and paste using this technique. In the fifth lesson, you'll be given the information 1 mile equals 1.609344 kilometers. Using this, you'll construct a formula that converts miles per hour in column C to kilometers per hour in column D. Then you'll notice that there are 5 decimal places shown in column D, and you'll learn how to remove those decimal places to show whole numbers. You'll also learn about paste options, and you'll learn how to access paste options from a smart tag. In the sixth lesson, you'll transpose a range. Here you can see that the car makes are shown in column A. When you transpose a range, the car makes will be shown in the header row, and the information that was in row 3 is shown in column A. In the seventh lesson, you'll learn to use the multiple item clipboard in order to copy and paste several pieces of information at the same time. In the eighth lesson, you'll use undo and redo. Both the simple undo and redo buttons and also multiple item undo and redo. In the ninth lesson, you'll copy some text from a Word document and paste it into Excel as a comment. In the 10th lesson, you'll view the comments that you pasted and learn how to space them out so that they look more attractive. In the 11th lesson, you'll learn how to print cell comments. This is a feature that very few Excel users even know exists. You'll first print some cell comments at the end of the worksheet. This is the actual printout, and then as displayed on the sheet. Once again, this is the actual printed page. In the 12th lesson, you'll understand absolute and relative cell references, a skill that is beyond the ability of the average Excel user. You'll take this formula and you'll convert H1 into an absolute reference. Using this absolute reference, you'll then construct this worksheet showing prices in both US dollars and Great Britain pounds by reference to the exchange rate shown in cell H1. In the 13th lesson, you'll understand mixed cell references. Mixed cell references are a very advanced Excel skill, and they're not even understood by many IT personnel. But you'll use mixed cell references to create this worksheet, showing the dollar price in 5 major world currencies by reference to the exchange rates in row 4. In the 14th lesson, you'll understand templates. You'll understand Microsoft's own example templates, and you'll also set a special folder for your own custom office templates. In the 15th lesson, you'll create a template from this worksheet, and then you'll save it as a template. In the 16th lesson, you'll use a template. First of all, one of Microsoft's examples. And then you'll create a workbook from the template that you saved in lesson 15. In lesson 17, you'll add an app to a workbook. Apps are an amazing new feature for Excel 2013. There's 2 types of apps. First of all, you'll add a temperature gauge to a worksheet. Now, temperature gauges don't exist in Excel, but by adding a third-party app, you'll learn how to add it. And then you'll use a task pane app, in this case, the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. In the 18th lesson, you'll freeze columns and rows. You can see that in this example, I've frozen row 1 and column A, so I can scroll to row 116 and column E and still be able to see the dates in column A and the headings in row 1. In the 19th lesson, you'll split the window into multiple panes. You'll add a horizontal split and you'll add a vertical split. In lesson 20, you'll use a sample file with many common spelling mistakes, and you'll use the spell checker to correct them all. You'll also learn how to set the dictionary language for different variations of the English language, such as English United States or English Great Britain. And as with all sessions, at the end of the session, there's an exercise to test your understanding of the skills learnt. And you're now ready to begin Session 3, Taking Your Skills to the Next Level.